We start this search for a deeper understanding with the idea of the augmenting path. Recall that in our original treatment of the max flow problem, we were given a flow over some graph, and we defined the residual network, which captured the ways in which we were allowed to modify this flow. This included adding backwards edges that went in the opposite direction from edges in the original. Augmenting paths, then, were paths over this residual network that went from the source to the sink and augmented the flow. In a network that arises from a bipartite matching problem, there are a few special phenomena that are worth noting. First, observe that all intermediate flows found by Ford-Fulkerson correspond to matchings as well. If there's flow across an internal edge, then it belongs in the matching. Also, because flows along edges are either 0 or 1, there are no anti-parallel edges in the residual network. That is to say, either the original edge is there or the reverse edge is there, never both. Moreover, the matched edges are the ones that have their edges reversed. Also, only unmatched vertices have an edge from the source to them or from them to the sink. Matched vertices have their edges reversed. The result of all of this is that any augmenting path must start at an unmatched vertex and then follow an unmatched edged, followed by a matched edge, followed by an unmatched edge, until eventually it reaches an unmatched vertex on the right-hand side, and then it can follow that edge to the sink. This realization allows us to strip away much of the complexity of flow networks and define an augmenting path for bipartite matching in more natural terms. We start by defining the more general concept of an alternating path. Giving a matching M, an alternating path is a path where edges are alternately in M and not in M. And an augmenting path is an alternating path where the first and the last vertex are unmatched. For example, in this graph here, going from this unmatched vertex in L to this matched vertex in R, back to this matched one in L, and then to this unmatched one in R, constitutes an augmenting path. We use it to augment the matching by making the unmatched edges matched and the matched edges unmatched, like so. This always increases the size of the matching because before we flipped, there was one more unmatched edge than matched edge in the path. So when we reverse the matched and unmatched edges, we increase the size of the matching by one. In fact, we can restate the Ford-Fulkerson method purely in these terms. We initialize the matching to the empty set, and then while there's an augmenting path, we update the matching to be the symmetric difference between the current matching and the path that we found. The symmetric difference includes an element if it's in exactly one of these sets. Or alternatively, you can think about it as the union of the two sets minus the things that are in both. The things that are in both here correspond to matched edges in the path. Remember that we flipped them to being unmatched. And finally, once there are no more augmenting paths, we simply return the matching.